This is the second part where we analyze this prototype to make an object detect another one when it enters its collider. Here in the corner I leave you a link to the previous video where we saw the basics of this prototype. In this video we're gonna talk about the scripts from the character and the collision detector. Here we are looking at the detection script. There are some public references for the audio source component, the enemy game object, and the sign. As they are public, they appear in the inspector and we can manually assign the objects we want. In a previous video, we talked about the onTrigger functions that are executed when one object enters the collider of another object, and if certain conditions are met. Here I have defined these functions. One is onTriggerEnter and the other is onTriggerExit. Both take a collider as parameter. If we point here with the mouse cursor, we will see this message appears. OnTriggerEnter is called when the collider other enters a trigger. Other would be the collider that is assigned to the object that is entering. So here we have the reference of that collider and we can apply actions to it. OnTriggerExit would be the opposite, when the collider other leaves the trigger. Notice that here is the message we saw in the console in the previous video. I am the trigger, someone has entered. And also there is a message when an object leaves the trigger. These messages are very useful because they let us know that the detection is indeed happening. If we don't see these messages in the console, probably the problem is in the components in the scene. Then we have this if statement to ask if the tag of the collider other is equal to player. If it's true, it means that the object that entered the collider has the player tag assigned. With that, we can differentiate what kind of objects enter the trigger and apply different actions depending on the tag. So if that's true, we enable the sign game object. We saw this in detail in the video on how to enable and disable game objects. You have the video here in the corner. With this other if statement, I make the instructions inside to be executed only once, the first time it happens. If the player leaves the trigger and comes back, these instructions are not going to be executed anymore. For that, I use a Boolean variable called activated, initialize it in false, and the condition to enter this if statement is that this variable is false. So in the first detection, we will always enter to this if statement. Inside, the first thing I do is make this variable true, and that prevents this part of the code to be executed again. Then whatever instructions we put inside are gonna be executed only once. Within the if statement, we activate the audio source component and the game objects. Here in the corner, I leave you a video about how to activate specific components. In the onTriggerExit function, that is when the object leaves the trigger, again we ask if the tag of the collider other is equal to player. If this is true, we disable the sign. So we enable the sign when the character enters and disables it when it leaves. And that would be all about the detection script. Finally, I wanted to show you the player script, which also has the onTriggerEnter functions defined. It simply prints out this message. I am the player, I enter the trigger. To show the fact that the onTrigger events are running in both scripts. That's all I wanted to show you. I hope you like it, don't forget to subscribe, and see you next time.